Hey friends, Azure Backup and Azure Site Recovery now have better integration with Azure Monitor, which makes it easier for business continuity and disaster recovery, or BCDR. Nandini Bajaj is here to show me how alerts in Azure Monitor and out-of-box reports in the Business Continuity Center help meet your requirements today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday and I'm going to learn all about Azure BCDR alerting and reporting solutions. Hi Nandini, how are you?
Hey, I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm very well. I'm going to learn all about business continuity. It's super important. People don't talk about it enough.
For sure. And I hope I can tell you all about BCDR alerting and reporting. So to start with, we've had alerts and reports as a major requirement from customers to be able to track everything that happens in their BCDR estate. That would include backup and site recovery in Azure. And we've had a few solutions, but they didn't seem enough for most of our customers. So we recently went live with the built-in alerts for backup and for site recovery. And we also enhanced our reporting solutions on the Business Continuity Center. So yes, I will go ahead and show you what our features now look like. So recently what we did is we onboarded our alerting solution onto the platform for monitoring called Azure Monitor. And here, what you can do, which you could not earlier, is you can send your alerting notifications, which are extremely important to have a prompt response, through to any of your notification channels. It is not limited to email anymore. It can be in through ITSM and webhook to any of your personal notification channels to be able to track them properly. To start with, the most important feature as to how you could do that is you could go to the Business Continuity Center on Azure portal and go to Alerts under Monitoring and Reporting. I will just move this out so we can see the entire screen. Here, right on top, you'll see the Manage Alerts option where you can go to Manage Alert Processing Rules and Action Groups. This together will help you configure your notifications. Basically, if you go to your alert processing rule, you can, I will just go to one of them to maybe show you what it looks like. So here you will be able to see that we've applied an action group. What happens when you apply an action group is all the alerts that are a part of the same action group will actually go into the same notification channel. So if we go to Manage Action Groups from here and click on Create, what will happen is, I will just skip some of these additions here and directly go to Actions. So if I go to Actions here, I will be able to see where I want to send these alerts to. So it could be ITSM, Logic App, Webhook. If I just select ITSM for now, I should be able to enter the subscription and the connection I want to send it to. And you will have it in your own system. And yeah, so that is one of the key roles of integrating Azure Monitor and alerts for backup and site recovery. Now, coming on to what we are offering as built-in alerts for backup and site recovery, we basically identified from all our customers that what is the most important alerting requirement for them. And for backup, it came out to be security and backup failure and restore. So we went ahead and enabled them by default for all of you. However, you can go ahead and disable it if you want. However, we do not allow you to disable your security alerts because it's extremely important. But if you do want to disable your restore and backup alerts, what you can do is go to Manage Built-in Alert Settings for Resources here. And this will list, This will list all the walls and their existing settings. So you can just click on the alerts, the update button under alert settings here. And yeah, this gives you all the options. So if I want to say disable my backup job failure, I can just go ahead and disable this. Similarly for site recovery, I can also go ahead and disable my replication issues and failover issues. For site recovery, we do not offer any security alerts by default. That is only available for backup, which is not disableable, if that's a word. But yeah, you cannot disable it. And after you select these, you can just go ahead and click on update, and you would have made the settings, or you would have configured the settings you wanted to. One more call out here is that for customers who have been using classic alerts all this while, you might want to start using the highly recommended built-in alerts that we offer now through Azure Monitor. And for that, you just need to go and check this box to say that I only want to use Azure Monitor for my backup and for my site recovery. And what this will do is this will stop you from getting repeated alerts of the same kind through two different channels, and you can just stick to built-in alerts.
And you want everyone to be on Azure Monitor, right? Azure Monitor is really your one-stop shopping center for all of these kinds of things. So if you're on the classic ways of doing notification channels, you really want to be on Azure Monitor. Is that correct?
That's absolutely correct. We want you to be on Azure Monitor for having the best possible experience, also to have all your alerts in one place rather than having it in multiple different places. That's absolutely correct.
Yeah, because there's more flexibility. It supports a much wider range of channels. You've got email, you've got your IT service management, webhooks, logic apps. Azure Monitor is where it's at, which is what we're learning today.
That's absolutely correct. Yes, that's what we want. Yes. So this is how you can move yourself to built-in alerts. This is also how you can configure your notification channels, etc. Business Continuity Center is our management platform. So here you can go ahead and also take a look at what your alerts look like and what are the different states they're in, etc. A very similar view is also visible through Azure Monitor. So you can go to Azure Monitor on your portal, select on alerts here, and you should be able to see the parent platform, which is the Azure Monitor. Everything that you could see on Business Continuity Center is also visible on the Azure Monitor. So feel free to take a look at that. We offer a lot of filters both on Business Continuity Center and Azure Monitor to be able to filter what you want to look at. So you can select what your solution is. So you say select your monitor service, add it, select on monitor service, and you can select Azure Backup and Site Recovery and only look at that. So that's hit apply, and I will only see those alerts in on my portal here. Similarly for your subscriptions, etc. This is mostly about the alerting capabilities we now offer with Azure Monitor for backup and site recovery.
When I see this many alerts, I realize that this is a person that doesn't have one virtual machine. They're running an entire enterprise. This is a whole IT department. And this is where I think I would want to get into more sophisticated reporting. I would need a more powerful tool to be able to view what's going on here.
Totally. And we've had this ask from a lot of our customers as well, when they're like, okay, we did see a lot of alerts and we did make a lot of actions, but how do I go back in time and actually look at all the historical evidence of what kind of backups failed, what happened to my backup estate in the past, what was the kind of usage, how much of the cloud resource am I using, and all of those other details. So for that purpose, we have the backup reports and site recovery reports. We've had backup reports as a consolidated set of reports for a while. However, we've been hearing that the reports do not cater to all the needs of our customers today, and it becomes extremely difficult to be able to capture just a part of the report for your specific need. So what we did is identified the top requirements from our customers as to what do they need to answer at the moment. And it mostly came from either an audit requirement perspective or from tracking the history perspective. So to cater to both of those things, we came up with some of these reports that you see here on the Business Continuity Center reports section. So here, these ones that you see, that is backup, configuration status, history, schedule and retention, and user triggered operations are for backup. And similarly for site recovery, the two most important ones were job history and replication history. Now, what is different for these out-of-box reports or these targeted reports is that, let me just open one of them. So if I open the ASR replication history, this is the first view you see where you can select your workspace subscription, and I'll keep it at all. You have to select some sort of workspaces, and we offer reporting for all the varieties of ASR support we have, that is both hybrid, VMware, and Azure to Azure. So you can select that from here. Let's say I keep it at hybrid for now, or I push it to Azure to be able to get you some data. Here you should be able to see your time range, some graphs that talk about the replication history, and some of the replication history items here, which talk about the health, the failover date, and other health errors that did happen in the past. Now, the X factor or the uniqueness of the report is that you can actually go ahead and edit each of these reports. All you have to do is click on the edit button that I did here. And each of the components that you see in the workbook here in your report are editable. So say I want to add another filter, I can click on edit here. And like you can see, I can add another parameter. So I click on add parameter and I add all the details that I want. Once I'm done doing that, I can click on done editing and it will show up. Similarly, if I want to say remove or add a certain column in the grid, I can go to the edit button again here. You will see the Custo query. So the workbooks are based on Custo, which is why you will see the Custo query written here. Here you can go ahead and again remove a certain column name from the project and it will get removed. If that's what you want, you can do that. You can add some if you want. You can literally do what you would do in Custo and have a visualization of it in the workbook. The same thing here again, you can test it by running the query and see what it looks like. Once you're done, click on done editing and it'll show up. And once you're done with all the components, you can click on done editing on top and that will save your report. What these building blocks or all these variety of reports actually are helping us with is to be able to curate a report for our own requirement, for our organization's need, whether it is for audit, what all do you want as a part of your audit report is what you can curate together and then download as per your need. In the future, we are working on being able to build an email feature so that you can send all these customized reports to your email for tracking purpose. However, today we just have, I'll just close this for now. However, for today, we only have the email opportunity for backup reports consolidated. That is the old version we were always supporting. But we do have things coming up for the new ones as well. So stay tuned for that. Yeah. That was mostly around the reports.
Cool. So where do I go and learn about this? If I've already maybe a classic alerts user, I'm just getting started with Azure Monitor, or I'm learning more about business continuity, where would you recommend that folks that are watching get started?
Yes. So you can go to our Learn Docs for Microsoft. I will just take you to one of them. So if you're looking at the site recovery alerts, then what you can do is go to site recovery, the site recovery documentation, go to use recovery services dashboard. You can see a built-in Azure Monitor alerts for site recovery in the contents here. Click on that. It will take you to all the alerting scenarios we do support today for ASR. We have a very similar documentation for backup, and all the steps required to be able to configure, etc., are available here.
Cool. So folks can check all of this information out in Microsoft Learn. They can go and learn in the documentation, get started. And we're going to have links in the show notes to all this information.
Fantastic. Lovely. Hope you do go through the documentation and try the feature. Make sure to reach out to us if you have any queries or recommendations for us.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Nandini, for teaching me all about alerting and reporting solutions for business continuity and disaster recovery. I'm learning lots today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it, watch more Azure Friday.